Let's be honest here for a moment. Most people in European cities don't have a garage. They park their cars curbside, like the cars you see around me here. Yet, in about 10 years, no gas-powered car will be able to be sold new in the European Union. All of these cars, one day, will be electric. But how are we going to do that? Where are people going to charge if you don't have a garage? Because right now, one of the benefits about having an electric car is that each morning when I get out of bed and I get down and I open my car door, my battery is full, ready to be used. But I have a garage. I have a house with solar panels. If we want to be able to charge all of these cars in the future, not too far away, some things are going to have to change. So when we talk about electric mobility, charging at home, let's be clear, is an absolute luxury. We're limited to homeowners with a garage. You might even also rent the place where you live, and that also might be an obstacle to putting a charger at your garage. So what do? We can't have electric mobility to be a luxury. I live in Madrid, where 60 to 70% of all cars park on the street, curbside, every night. And we need a solution just for that. So you might think that fast chargers everywhere would be the solution. It works for gasoline and diesel cars. Why wouldn't it work for electric cars? But you see, even at a fast charger, charging an electric car up to full takes quite a long time. The very fastest cars can do it maybe in half an hour, but the slower and more normal cars will take an hour, maybe even two, even at a fast charger, if you want to fill up the car. The whole concept of filling up an electric car just doesn't work very well if we're limited to fast charging. Furthermore, fast charging is a little bit more expensive. Of course, you need more powerful installations, more expensive equipment to do fast charging. So how do we solve that? How do we make sure that all these people with their cars parked right here can actually charge their cars? So one of the biggest benefits with an electric car is to slow charge it whenever it's parked. Most cars spend 90 to 95% of their life parked. Why not use that time to charge up the car? It's cheaper, it's better for the car, it's more convenient for the driver. There's one European city where hardly anybody parks in their own garage because the water level is so high that most underground garages would flood. Yet, they have one of the highest level of EV adoptions in Europe. So how did they do that? How in the world did they manage to get everybody charging?
Today, I'm heading to Amsterdam, a city that, much like Madrid, has narrow streets, lots of people living in apartments, and very little private parking. But unlike Spain, Amsterdam has managed to create a truly functional street charging system for electric vehicles, and I want to see it for myself. This trip isn't just about filming a few chargers, it's about understanding how a city with real-world limitations, space and cost and planning, can still make the transition to electric mobility work for everyone. If it works in Amsterdam, it can probably work anywhere. Amsterdam is a city that's famous for its canals, its bikes, and its tall people. But what many people don't know is that it also has over 8,000 public EV chargers installed right on the streets. That's more than any other city in Europe. And they're not hidden away in special EV hubs or behind locked parking gates. They're just there, integrated into the urban landscape, right next to where people already park their cars every single day. It's such a simple idea, but it has a massive impact. But what do the users actually think about this? Let's go and find somebody who actually used this system to charge their electric car.
Hello, Nils. How are you doing?
Hey, I'm good. How are you?
Very good. How does it work? What is the process for setting up a charge point like this?
Well, it started for me to have a request at Park and Charge. So okay. I filled in a form online, and within a day I heard they were going to install new stations. So it was pretty easy. The only thing you need to have is an electric car. So, but yeah, everyone can.
That's interesting. So you have to have an electric car registered, and then you can request a charge point.
Yes. Yeah. Otherwise, there's no use for you, of course. Yeah.
Of course. So there's tons of charging posts like this in all Amsterdam and around.
Yeah, there are lots of different operators as well. So I believe here in this city, you have like the Park and Charge stations, but also others. So there's a broad variety of charging stations.
Yeah. And here we have a sign saying that you have to be charging if you have to be stopped here.
Yeah.
But in other places, it's just in a normal parking spot?
Yeah. Sometimes you have like this, in Dutch, they call it like the pressure of parking or something. So when it's really high and there are a lot of cars who are not driving electrical, the municipality can decide not to place these signs so everyone can park there.
So what do I do, Nils?
Yeah, well, first you place it in a charging station and then we open this one. You plug it in your car. It's fairly easy. And to start the charging session, you're gonna get your, you can scan the QR with your phone.
Okay, let me get my phone.
Yeah.
It says, please plug in your vehicle to start charging.
Yeah, we did that.
And then start charging.
Yeah.
And we're charging.
Perfect. Yeah.
It was easy.
It's fairly easy, yeah.
So do people steal the cables?
No, they're stuck. So when you start charging, there's like a lock inside of this, so you cannot get it out.
Okay.
Especially as well here.
For the car?
Yeah.
And what about vandalism and other things? Is this a problem for it? Or do people, I don't know, break them open and steal things inside this?
I've never heard of it, no.
These are slow chargers, 7 or 11 kilowatts in most cases, and they're designed for exactly what city dwellers need most. Overnight charging where the car is already parked. You just plug in, scan a QR code or tap a card and that's it. No special accounts, no proprietary apps, no need to plan your life around it. They're safe, locked while in use and placed where there's space available. Sidewalks, canal edges, lamppost. There's no need for ultra rapid chargers on every corner in a city. What people really need is convenience. I've come to the headquarters of Quello, the company behind many of the chargers I've seen around Amsterdam. They currently manage more than 15,000 public charging points across Europe, including some in Spain. But what interests me the most is how they manage to install all these chargers in public spaces so quickly and efficiently.
I'm Daniel Perbo, work for Quello in the Netherlands.
Why do you install slow chargers and not just fast chargers everywhere?
And we install chargers for people who don't have an own parking spot, and obviously Amsterdam, streets are very busy. Not everyone can have their own parking spot in front of their house. Right now you pay a small fee per hour for the connection tariff, and you also pay a fee per kilowatt hour. And this changes every month or a couple months, I would say.
And how long time does it take to install the new charger?
We have a request for a charge pool. So someone wants to have a public charger in their area and there's none, or The ones existing are always full. So a person comes up to our company and asks for a new charger. And this is a starting point, obviously, for us.
So it's the user that starts the process?
Yeah,
not the municipality or the city?
The user starts the process.
Okay.
What we do, the starting point is we have a contract with the municipality. And then within this contract, the user can ask for a new charging point. Well, if the user does not ask for a new charging point, then nothing starts.
So it's a challenge to find the right places to install them. This is a difficult process?
Yes. Yes, this is a process, and this takes, with each new charger, it takes more time because the easy spots are already taken and the harder spots are left. So we see that it takes more and more time to find the good places because there are already a lot of chargers, but the demand's even growing, so we need more spaces.
So there's no cost for the user and there's no cost for the municipality to install a charger. All this is an upfront cost that you cover?
Exactly, yeah. The municipality does not cover any costs upfront, and the user does. The user who requests the charging pole is also free of cost.
To understand how all of this really works, how street chargers go from an idea to something you can plug into, I sat down with someone who's been working on this for years.
My name is Jeroen Franke. I am the managing director of Quello Benelux. I've been in the industry of charging equipment since 2014. And I worked for companies who tried to be everything to everybody, with the risk, of course, of being nothing to nobody.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing that I really liked about Quello is that there is a tremendous focus on one single thing, and that is AC charging in the public area. So we do one thing and we do it really well. For that, you basically have to look at the paradigm shift that you go through as a user when you transition from an ICE car, a petrol car, to an electric vehicle? With a petrol car, you have a tank of gas, you start driving, and whenever the red light turns up, you go to a gas station and you fill your car. The paradigm shift that you go through when you drive electric is that you start the day with a full battery. Mm-hmm. And every time you arrive somewhere where you are for more than perhaps 1 hour, you fill up your tank like you would your iPhone. So there's multi-purposes to AC charging, which is very different from DC charging, which is mostly in corridors, so on your way somewhere, when you need a range extension to whatever range your car has. Mm-hmm. So the two are very different. I think I've been driving electric since 2015. I can count the number of times that I've used DC charging on two hands. Because in the Netherlands, in a country like the Netherlands, when your range is, you know, on an average day, perhaps at this limit, it's 300 kilometers, AC charging is more than enough. Mm-hmm. And it's while you're doing other stuff. You don't have to wait for your car to get full. Yeah, your car charges up when you're asleep, when you're at home, when you're in during an appointment or at dinner.
So maybe slow charging is not the right way of calling it. Maybe it's more like unattended charging.
Yeah, it's unattended charging. It's AC charging. I think all AC charging with an average of 11 kilowatt is fast charging. Mm-hmm. I drive a Tesla with quite a substantial battery, and it only takes me on average 2 or 3 hours to top it up. Mm-hmm. So that's still pretty fast. So what happens when I drive back from Belgium to the Netherlands and my car is running low? Then I stop at a DC charger, I put in 100 kilometers, I drive home, and then I connect it to AC charging again, because it's a waste of time to use DC charging and wait while it's being charged. So unattended charging is a good term, actually. Yeah. In the city of Amsterdam, it all started with the desire to have cleaner air for its citizens. Mm-hmm. Therefore, being a big fan of electric vehicles, electric driving, they wanted to accommodate the citizens. And then we experimented. So we started looking at strategic locations for chargers, which in some instances are very obvious, let's say near museums or near streets where people could afford a Tesla, which was one of the first high-end electric vehicles that people bought. But over time, it shifted from strategic placements to customer-driven placements. So customers now in the Netherlands, or I shouldn't say customers, I should say EV drivers, they go onto the website of the community or suppliers like us, CPOs like us, and they request a charger for their location. Then the city or the CPO checks what the usage is of stations surrounding that. And if all lights are green, then a request is being put forward to the city for an additional charger. So that shifted very much from trial by error and just figuring out where to place chargers and how to accommodate for it, to a very well organized setup that it is today. I don't think that when the petrol car was invented and there was diesel, there was ever a discussion whether diesel or petrol would win. They mm-hmm. coexist. I think there will always be a demand for other fuels than electric. I don't think it's the aim to electrify everything, but there is a very good reason to decarbonize our transport.
Of course. So is there an upper limit to how many electric cars and infrastructure like Amsterdam can take?
I am sure that there is. We have some net congestion in the Netherlands already. The electricity net is a zero-sum game. So whatever you put in, if you generate electricity, it has to go out at the same time. You can't store it on the grid itself. Mm-hmm. So that is a balancing act that is quite substantial. And the grid operators have difficulty balancing the net. They also have difficulty in order to organize for the peak moments in the day. So we as CPOs are trying to help out by offering mitigating rules for against net congestion. I foresee a bright future for us, but also for companies like us.
There's plenty of room for a lot of different operators.
Absolutely.
There's a lot of cars to be charged.
Competition keeps us sharp.
So if the Dutch can do it, so can the rest of us. Whether that's a light pole, we could put a charger that could charge up two cars overnight. And with the amount of light poles you see around, we'd have plenty to charge up all the cars on the street. If there's no technical limitation, then why can't we have a charger next to each light pole? The answer to me is quite obvious. There's a lack of knowledge and there's a lack of political willpower. So what can we do about it? If you're part of any local administration, of course, think about this, bring this up in your assemblies and consider that using an electric vehicle is fundamentally different to using an ICE car. If you're interested in having an electric vehicle, but you don't have a place to charge it, contact your municipality and let them know that you need them to help you drive something cleaner. And if you're interested in contacting Aquello, who helped me make this video, I will leave their contact details down in the description below. Thank you very much for watching. I hope to see you again soon here back on Totally Electric.